Hello, Southwest Florida. Welcome back to Leap This Live. We're so thrilled to get in here. Two of Southwest Florida's best attorneys, and certainly on a national level, the firm is one of the top law firms in the country. And so we're so thrilled to get the North Law Firm in here. You've been hearing about the Babcock case, and they're here to unpack it because they are the attorneys on that very important case. Gentlemen, welcome to Leap This Live.
Thank you for having us.
Glad to be here.
Good to get you.
As always.
Especially in such a historic moment when we talk about the Babcock case. The Babcock neighborhood school has gotten in a certain situation as it relates to racism and discrimination. And it's so thrilling to know that we have one of the top law firms in the country that's managing that case. For a little background on the case, let's take a look.
N-word, cotton picker, monkey, and much more, all words that were allegedly used to torment a classmate and teammate. A student at Babcock Neighborhood School says that she went through racial discrimination and bullying from people that she played sports with. Listen to what teammates said on this video during a school trip.
She didn't pick her cotton this morning. Racism?
Now, the family wants someone held accountable for what their child went through. WINK News anchor Annette Montgomery joins us now live from Babcock Neighborhood School. Annette, what's the family doing about it?
Well, Russ and Amanda, this 33-page lawsuit details the racial slurs, discrimination, and bullying a student here at Babcock Neighborhood School says they went through. Now, this lawsuit says that student was called names like monkey and cotton picker, as well as physically assaulted during a school-sanctioned trip. Now, the attorneys representing that family told me they want justice, and not only for the school to be held accountable, but also the parents of the children who allegedly let this happen.
She didn't pick her cotton this morning.
This is just one of the videos that details the taunting Grace Clay, a high school student at Babcock Neighborhood School, says she endured on an overnight school-sanctioned trip.
She was, you know, a student on the volleyball team, and they're at an away game in a hotel, and a lot of the students, other volleyball players, white students, they held her down, and they continued to hit her with a pillow and were saying, you know, did you pick your cotton? Pick your cotton, get the black one, things of that nature.
Attorney Joseph North Jr. is representing Clay in this lawsuit against Babcock Neighborhood School, the owner, and six parents. The lawsuit walks us through some of the other forms of racial discrimination and slurs. He says his client, as well as other students at Babcock Neighborhood School, were subjected to.
They were called the N-word in class in front of teachers. Well, as far as those racial slurs, we're talking about overt racism, name-calling, and racial epithets being hurled, you know, throughout semesters. There's new families who have reached out, and we actually are in the process of filing a lawsuit this afternoon. And with another client whose child also went to Babcock, we likely will be filing a third lawsuit before the end of this week.
The lawsuit claims the school was made aware of these allegations. This is an email between Principal Amanda Sanford and Clay's mother about this video from the school volleyball trip. In it, Sanford says, "We have investigated this situation. While the language is inappropriate, it is determined to not be racially discriminatory." Now Clay's family wants one thing.
In a word, justice. A lot of the families, they want to see change at Babcock, whether that's administrative, new policies, diversity and inclusion board. We want to see change.
And I did reach out to the Charlotte County School District for comment, as Babcock Neighborhood School is a public charter school. Now, I didn't get comment back from them. They actually just referred me to leaders here. But Attorney Joe North did tell me after this incident, his client, along with other parents of students here, got a letter sent home. Now, that letter said the school was creating a student civility task force. I'll have more on that on WINK News at 6. Live from Babcock Ranch, Annette Montgomery, WINK News.
We got a chance to see that little background on it, but a lot has happened since then. But the key thing is that the North Law Firm is Johnny on the spot on this case. How is this a discrimination case, Joe North?
Well, as we've seen in the video, our client was called the black one, cotton picker, the N-word, monkey, and it's a discrimination case because those are racially discriminatory words. And the parents brought this to the attention of the school. The school, for whatever reason, did not believe that it was racially discriminatory. And that's the reason why the parents called us to represent them, because they were not getting any results with the school.
Smart parents. The Babcock Neighborhood School, Joseph North Jr., how did the North Law Firm, once you got that phone call, how did you get deeply involved in the process?
Well, as soon as we got the call, we went straight to investigating and just initiating the legal process. And so it started off with one call, and, you know, more families have come forward. And so we've been involved as far as making sure that we're not wasting any time, and it's full steam ahead to make sure that we can get these families their legal rights and justice as soon as possible.
You say families. There's more than one family. How many families right now do we know about, and are there others who could be a part of this whole process?
Yes, there are multiple families, unfortunately. And so we filed three lawsuits on behalf of three different families, and there's been two more families who have reached out in the last couple of days. One of those families actually has two or three students who attended Babcock at some time. And again, unfortunately, we expect that there's probably more families who will be coming forward due to how pervasive the racism, harassment, and bullying was at Babcock Neighborhood School.
Unbelievable. Now, Joe, attorney, Joseph and Joe, people, if you're wondering, yes, wherever you're watching this around the world, it's his son and father. Joe, is it just limited to students?
And no, we know of a teacher,
breaking news,
Indian descent, who was racially discriminated against in her own classroom, that she was called certain words in the classroom by some of her students. She left the room in tears, complained to the school, and even in her instance, the school did nothing. And when the students see that nothing has happened to the students who are victimizing the teacher, then they don't have any reason to believe that their concern will be heard.
Neighborhood.
So they feel helpless.
Babcock Neighborhood School. For people who are watching who may not be familiar with the demographics, the area where the school is located, in a broader sense, I'll let people know we're in the southwest quadrant of the state of Florida. If you're looking at it on the map, near a city called Fort Myers, we're near Charlotte County and Naples, Collier County. But Joe, I want you to kind of give people an idea, where is Babcock Neighborhood School, and a general idea that you can observe prima facie in terms of the racial demographics?
Well, it's on the eastern part of Lee County and Charlotte County. About 90% of the property sits in Charlotte County, and about 10% sits in Lee County. But it's just over the Charlotte-Lee County lines off of 31.
Okay. The city would be, the city called back, what's the city called?
It is not a city, it's a development, it's a community.
Oh, okay.
But they anticipate having more than 50,000 residents within how many years?
Oh, I think just a few more years.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, people who didn't know about Babcock, they're going to know a lot about Babcock in the coming years, because this type of thing is going to bring a lot of attention. I see it personally as a seminal case in history, because we're talking discrimination, but there are other components to this, Joseph North, than discrimination that you can unpack for us right now.
Right. And so there's discrimination, mm-hmm. There's harassment, and there's bullying. And that's why we've made different counts in our lawsuits to reflect everything that's happening. And so we've sued for negligent supervision of students, which is a claim that is asserted when the teachers aren't doing their job. And the teacher's job is to make sure, A, the kids are educated, but two, to make sure they're safe and supervised. And so we've also included for negligent security, because as a school and a property, you have a duty to make sure that everyone is safe from crime. And some of these students that we represent have actually been subjected to crime, whether it's assaults or batteries and false imprisonments. So we've made a number of different claims to reflect all that's happened, as you said, not just racial discrimination, but actually, you know, hate crimes and harassment and severe bullying and things of that nature.
Outstanding. Attorney Joe, both attorneys, I'll try to remember to say that from time to time, but One of the things about the North law firm that I've observed over the many years of observing you guys, when you take on cases, you generally leave things better than what you found them for society. People fix things. They improve on how they're doing things. The consciousness is raised in terms of we got to do better with this. We got to do better with that. We got to be better with making it safer for people and all these types of things. That's very important to you. And when as this case rolls down, what do you hope would be the final results in terms of a better society and the way we handle people in public places and certainly in schools?
I'm glad that you mentioned that, because a lot of times people think that the lawyer is there just to get compensation for the clients. And yes, that is very important that we get our clients compensated. But in addition to that, and maybe even more important, is we've got to fix that culture at the school so that these students and students coming behind them can go and get education, can make friends, and feel safe. And what we're going to do at Babcock, other schools, even public schools, private schools, will be watching, and they will know that when their students are subjected to this type of discrimination or harassment or bullying, that they've got to do something about it to stop it and not just let it go on and on and on and become rampant. So we're hoping, and we're going to make sure of that this case, that these lawsuits will make it better for the students who are enrolled now and students to come behind them. Mm-hmm.
And overall, we talked about how to lead the place better. What do you hope to achieve ultimately?
I believe that some of the teachers, principals, administrators who've allowed this to happen, that they won't be on that campus moving forward. They didn't do their job, so they can't keep their job. Get someone in there who is going to be more sensitive to what's happening and protect the students as these former administrators should have.
Attorney Joseph, what do you say to the people who are saying, how in the world do you expect that the teachers and administrators and all of them to be responsible and the parents for the act of their children?
I would say, look at the hard evidence and what's happening in this case. We're not talking about racism that's happening behind closed doors or in secret meetings. We're talking about in classrooms, in the presence of teachers, students calling Black students the N-word. We're talking about students using the teacher's blackboard or whiteboard rather, and using hangman game to use the N-word. We're talking about students with apps on their phone that have gunshots and slave whips. And, you know, we mentioned it earlier. The principal saw the video of these girls yelling, racism, racism, get the Black one, cotton picker. And she saw the video and decided that was not discriminatory. So we're not asking teachers to be superheroes. We're asking them to quite simply do their job and do what's reasonable. And so when all of this is right at your front door, pervasive throughout the whole school, elementary, middle, and high school, you have an obligation to do something. And they didn't.
Unbelievable. You guys, students of law, this kind of rings like what progress has been made. We know on the surface that we feel that some progress has been made in terms of how people are being treated in the laws that are on the books and discrimination laws. But when we see things like this come to the fore, you, a young attorney now out of law school, been practicing for some years now. Does it say, hey, we're still dealing with a lot of things that we thought that the civil rights movement had taken care of?
It's bothersome. And sure, there has been some progress made over the last, you know, few decades. But in many ways, when I look at this case and we start peeling back the layers of evidence, it looks like racism was sort of brought into the 21st century, because instead of it being Black water fountains and white water fountains, now they have applications on fancy iPhones that can perpetuate racism. Now you're using social media and Photoshop to show, you know, instead of Black children actually being in cotton fields, now you're using Photoshop to transpose them in cotton fields. Mm-hmm. And so it's sickening, but if there is a silver lining in this case, it's that for those people who are blind to racism in 2023, now you can no longer be, because it's right in front of your face. It's right on your TV screen.
Call Joe, call Joe. Attorney Joe North, the technology. Joseph just laid out some of the advancements in technology and how it's playing into the modern day discrimination and affecting people's rights to just enjoy themselves, go to school, go wherever they want to do and enjoy their lives. Technology also plays a role here in terms of photos that you've been able to get, emails and text messages that you've been able to see. I want you to expound a bit on what Joseph just said about we got evidence.
Yeah, so
I know you're not going to unveil it all here, but you got other stuff. Give me some bases that have been in public already.
A lot of times in these cases, it comes down to he said, she said.
Mm-hmm.
And we have two witnesses or multiple witnesses, and the six people sitting on the jury will have to decide, well, what really happened here? Who should I believe? Well, because of technology, we don't have that concern in this case because we've got hard evidence, as Joseph just talked about.
Mm-hmm.
We've got videos because, you know, everybody has a cell phone in his or her hand these days. We've got emails, and those are things that cannot be disputed. We can't say your eyes are lying to you or your ears are lying to you. Whatever the video shows, it shows. Whatever the emails say, they say. And it gets back to what's so disturbing about this case. When the school was presented with that hard evidence, not that he said, she said, but with the hard evidence, they put their heads in the sand, hoped that it would go away, but did nothing to make it go away. So today's technology actually helps the case.
Things are about to change. Society is about to change as a result of this case. It's going to require a lot of people to do a lot of things to protect themselves. We're talking about Babcock Neighborhood Elementary, Babcock Neighborhood School.
Yeah.
Or do you feel that this is not just limited to that particular school, what we're seeing now coming to the fore?
We've actually received calls from other schools, some public schools as well. So I've known before and I know now that this type of discrimination and bullying, it does happen throughout all of the schools. But what's unique about Babcock is that Babcock was faced with what was happening and did nothing about it. I think at most schools, the principals and administrators do try to correct the problem, but we didn't have that at Babcock. And that's the reason why we filed these lawsuits.
However, people who are watching this and say, hey, this is happening at my school. Hey, no matter where they are in the country or in the world for that matter, this is happening. I see things that a North law firm is talking about right now that we can document and we know it's happening to us, to our family, to me as an administrator, as a teacher, as a cook, a janitor, what have we. Is it okay right now for them to start thinking about those things and the fact that they may want to contact you guys and run it by you?
Yes, absolutely. And I know that sometimes it's tough to come forward. There's always the first one. But I say to anyone out there who's been subjected to that type of discrimination or victimization, step forward. Do it for yourself. Do it for those who are coming behind you. And you'll have a lot of support. And we're there to support you.
Attorney Joseph, when people send their children off to school, get on the bus, drop them off at school, they should expect their kid to experience what in that school?
When you walk into a classroom or on a campus, you should feel sacred. And from what we've learned already, so many of the kids at Babcock felt hatred and not sacred.
Ooh.
And as someone who from kindergarten through graduating law school spent over 20 years of my life as a student, I know how important education and school is. And for some people, school is the escape from their family problems or things happening outside of the school walls. So for that to be the inverse at Babcock is why we know that has to be eradicated as far as all the hatred and racism. And it's actually never appropriate and truly against the law to have a culture of chaos and hatred at a school.
The National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, the NAACP, the oldest civil rights organization in the world. Many have said that in the modern day, in 2023 and 21st century, since progress has been made so much, we've had a black president and all that, Oprah Winfrey, Michael Jordan, and so on and so forth. We don't even need an NAACP. What do you have to say to that, Attorney Joe North?
We absolutely need the NAACP. Founded in 1909, for noble causes, but still those noble causes exist today. You know why? Just look at the Babcock case. The NAACP was the first to shine its light on this problem. And without the NAACP around the country, a lot of problems would not be known. They would be swept under the rug. So I say that the NAACP was needed then, is needed now, and it's going to be needed tomorrow.
One of the most successful and most seminal attorneys in history relating to the NAACP was Thurgood Marshall. Many people know that he went on to become Supreme Court Justice. But he did a lot of work on the ground in the early stages to make opportunities for people like yourself. I'm sure you have a lot of respect for Thurgood Marshall. I see this case, that's me, I see this case in the same light as the work of people like Thurgood Marshall did on the ground. So I'm so glad that at this moment in history, we have people like the North Law Firm here in this particular geographical area, able to track this at a personal, close level to make sure that things don't fall below the cracks. I said all that to say this is, one, what is your thoughts on Thurgood Marshall and what he meant to you? Joseph, what is your thoughts on Thurgood Marshall and what he meant to you? We'll start right here.
Thurgood Marshall, one of the greatest, no, the greatest civil rights attorney ever to grace this earth. And what a lot of people don't know is he didn't make any money doing it. He did it because it was the right thing to do. And he was honored and recognized for his efforts by becoming the United States Supreme Court Justice. And he indeed paved the way for a lot of what we're doing today and in large part for who we are today. So I am just honored to follow in his footsteps and fighting for the civil rights of others.
Absolutely. And I'm just happy to be right here at this moment so we can make sure that we paint the full picture.
Absolutely. And I think you said it all, Thurgood Marshall, he's the gold standard when it comes to civil advocacy. And in the same way that he fought so fervently as an attorney, it takes an all hands on deck approach. As far as you talk about the NAACP's involvement, we're doing our best to make change as well. And this platform, Lee Pitts Live, you know, is all hands on deck contributing towards a common goal, which is to, you know, eradicate racism and really fight for the rights of everyone and bring 2023 to how it should be and not how it currently is.
Thurgood Marshall handled cases all around the country. Is it fair to say that the North, in it, as it relates to these types of cases, you're open for business?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Any school, any person, anywhere will handle the case. Mm-hmm.
Joseph, Joe, when we say schools, that would include colleges, all types of educational institutions.
Yes. So, you know, public school, private school, colleges, and even businesses, you know, because businesses are not exempt. If they've got a discriminatory practice going on and someone is victimized by it, they can call us as well.
Experience. Over 30 years of experience, also experiences in cases, similarities, in fact, similarly thereof, and different derivatives, that counts in terms of getting justice. Speak to that. Yes. You have experience.
Yes, absolutely. As you know, I've been doing this now for more than 30 years. And when I have a case, especially of this magnitude, that affects so many different people, well, guess what? This case sits on my desk. It doesn't go into the file cabinet. And I pour all of my 33 years of experience into this case to get justice for these clients.
If I'm looking at this as a parent myself too, and this is really near and dear to me, Joseph, and I'm wondering what's going on in my household, what is my child experiencing at school, and what can I do that may trigger to let me know that I'm experiencing something similar to this, my child, or me as an educator or a person who's working in the public school system or colleges and private and all of that. What are some things they should look at and say, we might have a case here?
As a parent, if you know your child has gone through discrimination, harassment, bullying, and you can see that they've been hurt physically or sometimes mentally, which can even be more dangerous than a physical injury, you know, reach out and seek representation. You know, give us a call. Mm-hmm. And we'll assess and determine whether you have an actionable case to seek justice, mm-hmm. whether that's against a private school, a public school, a charter school, a university, a business, because, you know, one thing about this country is we have our rights and sometimes you have to fight for them. And so that's what we do. And you might have a case if you've been subject to that.
Coach Prime, he's not from here. I mean, he's from here, but we know him for Colorado. He said, I'm not hard to find. Deion Sanders is from Fort Myers. I'm not hard to find. Big fan of Coach Prime, right?
Huge, huge fan of Coach Prime, also of Coach Cheney. In fact, I'm going out there in about 3 weeks to watch a game live with them. So, yeah.
I said that. You said, where are you going with this? I said that to say the North Law Firm is not hard to find. Tell them how to find you.
Well, we're easy. On any social media platform, our telephone number is 239-337-1191. And our website is thenorthlawfirm.com.
Not hard to find.
Not hard to find.
Y'all like that?
I like that.
Let me bump you out.
Thank you for all you do.
Hey,
thank you.
Stay right there. The saying goes on this particular show, for those who say it can't be done, and this is like really real, they're usually interrupted by those who are doing it, like the North Law Firm. And Miami may have the oranges, but the North Law Firm has got the
juice.
They got the juice. They will solve your cases. Give them a call.
And we're not hard to find.
We'll see.
I met Joe 20 years ago at church, and I had a problem with an accident, and he helped. My experience with Joe was excellent. I couldn't have had a better attorney than him. As a matter of fact, I don't think there's any other ones out there better than him. He came in and he told me the amount that I was going to be receiving. Oh, wow. I was so excited. I gave him a big hug.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, everybody. This is Lee. I'm so glad that you watched that particular show. And if you enjoyed that show, we got other shows like that. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel. Watch Lee Pitts Live on demand anytime. And also hit us up on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live, and there you go.